I'm Craig Fuller, principal tuba of the Omaha Symphony, and I'm here today to talk a little bit about Symphonie Fantastique and the tuba's role in this really important work written by Hector Berlioz. He wrote it in 1830, and it's an example of program music as opposed to absolute music. You might think of something like a Beethoven symphony as being absolute music. It was just music written to be listened to with no story attached. Well, Symphonie Fantastique is the exact opposite of that. It's a very programmatic piece, and basically, it's a psychotic dream that Berlioz lives through, and in the end, he witnesses his own death in a march to the scaffold. And then the tuba's role is part of what's called the Dies Ire. It's an old, it was a song, I guess you could say. It was part of a Requiem Mass. It was the Day of Wrath. And it was what you would call Gregorian chant. And it might have sounded somewhat like this. Certainly someone would sing it. A man, of course, because only men were allowed to sing in church. Sorry, ladies, just wasn't a good time for you. Much better now. Now this is the Day of Wrath as it would be performed while singing. That's just a portion of it. And of course, it was sung in Latin because that was the language of the church at that time and in some congregations even today. So that melody was taken by Hector Berlioz among many other composers. As a matter of fact, Rachmaninoff used it in 12 of his major pieces. But Berlioz used this as the kind of Day of Atonement, Day of Wrath, and kind of portraying his own death. And so here's what the tuba part sounds like. As a matter of fact, it was originally an ophicleide part, which is an antiquated instrument. If you kind of think of a baritone saxophone with a tuba mouthpiece, it was a really god-awful sound. And Berlioz later in his life said he preferred the tuba on that part. So here's how part of it goes in the beginning of the Dies Ire, The Witch's Sabbath by Hector Berlioz. So you can hear that it's much more articulate, much more scary sounding, I think, than the original voice part that Berlioz used. And the way we practice something like that is to isolate on getting a good breath, playing any wind instrument. The breath is really the key. So we want to pull in a nice, comfortable breath, and then use that up. Notice when I took a big breath, it wasn't a sound like this or it didn't have friction in it. I call that a frictionless breath, and we want to pull that in. Let's all practice that right now. Just take that really warm, frictionless breath in and out. And that's the kind of air that we need to use playing really any wind instrument. ¶¶